Illinois Tollway's Building for Success webinar series. If you have joined us previously, welcome back. If this is your first time tuning into our weekly series, we're glad you set aside time in your busy day to spend it with us. I'd like to go over some housekeeping items before we begin today's presentation. First, everyone will be muted. If you would like to submit a question, please use the chat box function and include your name and company affiliation so we know who you are. If you are joining us by phone or via computer or laptop, the presentation will be recorded and posted on the Tollway's website afterwards. And finally, please take a few moments to fill out the brief survey following the presentation. We appreciate your feedback and would love to hear how you learned about today's event and if you have any suggestion for future topics. The Department of Diversity and Strategic Development is a driving force for increasing economic opportunities in the diverse communities we serve. Through our various programs and initiatives, the Tollway takes an active role in providing access to economic opportunities for small, diverse, and veteran businesses and individuals in the heavy highway construction industry. Today, my department is heavily focused on increased training and education opportunities like today's webinar. Working with the internal departments to identify economic opportunities for diverse firms, recruiting new entrants, and supporting programs and initiatives for historically underserved individuals. Today's webinar series topic is Small Business Initiative Plaza Improvement Contracts. Our presenters are Laura Thompson and Marlene Vick. Nearly 60 people have registered for today's event, so there's a fair amount of interest in this topic, and I look forward to what the speakers have to say. Now, I will turn it over to Marlene.
Good afternoon, everyone. As an economic engine for the region, the Tollway provides small, diverse, and veteran businesses and individuals with opportunities to grow and succeed through our training programs, strategic partnerships, and investments in infrastructure. A critical way the Tollway enables disadvantaged firms to compete for contracting opportunities is through the Small Business Initiative, or SBI. SBI is an expansion of the state's small business program, which has been in place for years and is an initiative of the Chief Procurement Office. SBI identifies certain construction contracts, generally with values of $5 million or less, that only registered small businesses can perform on as prime and subcontractors. Through SBI, the Tollway can establish diversity goals on select construction contracts, as well as self-performance goals for primes of up to 40%. In this one in particular, it is 15%, depending on the scopes of work. This helps to ensure that the financial benefits of SBI work remain with small businesses and incentivize them to participate on projects as primes. It is important to note that bidders must be registered in the state's Small Business Set-Aside program and the Tollway's SBI programs at the time that the bids are submitted. The good news is every small business registered with the state is eligible. The Tollway's SBI follows guidelines established by the CPO's office, which defines a construction small business as having gross revenues of $14 million or less annually. Next, the Tollway would consider the relevant specifications on a project-by-project basis that may include pre-qualification with either the Illinois Department of Transportation or the Capital Development Board. Finally, the Tollway has established a brief application process to affirm all eligible businesses are registered with the state, which begins with the Chief Procurement Office using the IPG. This is a chart that will show you what you need to do in terms of steps to register with the SBI program. If you are new to the Tollway and to the Small Business Set-Aside program, you need to register with both. Please ensure that you give yourself enough time to register with the state, as that process may take up to 14 business days. If the firm is already registered with the small business program, then they just need to complete the SBI application and turn it into the tollway. If your firm has registered with both, you're in good shape. All you need to do is stay up to date with the construction bid letting schedule on the tollway's website and go to the online plan room. Later in this presentation, we'll talk about the resources available to all firms interested in participating in tollway contracts. This is a snapshot of the application process and how you can learn about tollway alerts. Now I'll turn over the presentation to Laura Thompson.
Thank you, Marlene. I'm Laura Thompson, a senior project engineer with Illinois Tollway, assigned to the Plaza Improvement Contract. As the tollway looks for constant modernization to the system, a number of improvements are planned to the plazas across the system. We are excited that these contracts are being presented to help develop greater small business opportunities, a priority for our agency. Today, I'm going to talk about what is included in these contracts, a highlight of the scope of work, and cover some general information on the bidding process. As we look to complete this initiative, these contracts will include scope anticipated to involve pavement marking, sign removal, sign installation, electrical work, pavement rehabilitation, and maintenance of traffic, among other items. Specific details are included in the bid documents, and we'll discuss where those resources are available later in the presentation. The contract will vary in size and scope and will range from approximately $400,000 to $2 million, and the plaza locations will be grouped together per contract. These contracts will not require an IDOT pre-qualification, and prospective bidders should review the tollway's ROSIP insurance program required for these contracts. We anticipate advertising 9 contracts over the coming weeks, with work starting as early as May. A number of the contracts have already been advertised and are available to the public. This slide further illustrates where you can find this information on the website and provides an overview of the page. All of the tollway's contracting opportunities are posted in advance of the advertisement on our bid letting schedule on the website. This is updated frequently to provide the contracting community early indication of upcoming contracts. If you are not familiar, the bid letting schedule provides prospective bidders the anticipated advertisement date, bid opening date, the cost magnitude, and general timeline of the contract. You can find this document posted under the Doing Business section of the tollway and in the tab under Construction and Engineering. As part of the Plaza Improvement Contract, this slide highlights the general type of work we're looking for in each of these contracts. At each of the plazas, but furthermore detailed in the contract documents, there will be an element of sign installation and removal, pavement and infrastructure and improvements, electrical work, pavement marking installation and removal, and maintenance of traffic during construction. While work is not site-specific, the photos and descriptions give you a general idea of the type of work that is being sought out. The information provided on this slide is for illustrative purposes only, and bidders should review the plans and specifications on the tollway's website for further or for specific contract requirements. Sign removal and installation is anticipated for all contracts. This scope may include ground-mounted signs adjacent to the roadway, canopy mounted signs, and signs mounted on overhead and cantilevered structures. There may be a select number of contracts that will include bridge mounted signage. Majority of the signage is anticipated to be fabricated by the Illinois Tollway Sign Shop for contractor pickup and installation. Prioritization amongst the contractors for the pickup will be heavily coordinated with the Tollway's assigned construction management team. The scope for pavement infrastructure improvements will include the removal and installation of concrete for the installation of subsequent equipment. Depending on the contract, some locations will require pavement patching and saw cutting. The electrical work for the contract will vary depending on the plaza location. New conduit and wiring may be necessary depending on the scope at each plaza and at individual lanes. The installation of this infrastructure will also depend on the existing conditions of the site and whether the raceways are installed overhead, underground, or within the existing walkway infrastructure. The electrical scope for each project will be detailed at a pre-activity walkthrough in advance of construction with the awarded contractor. Due to the changes in the lane configuration at each plaza, contracts will include work for pavement striping removal and subsequently striping installation. The pavement will require grooving, but will be indicated on the contract document. In order to complete this work, the contractor will need to install shoulder and or lane closures to provide a safe working environment. This will be further coordinated heavily with the Tollway's construction management team and maintenance department. Maintenance of traffic, often referred to as MOT, will be a key component to completing the work on these contracts. Contractors may require shoulder and lane closures to complete the intended scope of these contracts. Some installation of overhead roadway signage may require 15-minute full closures of the roadway. This will be completed with the assistance of our Illinois State Police and will be discussed and coordinated in more detail with the contractor and the construction management team. The Tollway has several manuals on the website to aid in completing this work, and we'll be working closely with the contractors to effectively deliver this work to the motoring public and deliver a quality product to the tollway. The contractor should review the Illinois Tollway and IDOT standard and supplemental specifications and drawings and be familiar with those that are incorporated as part of the contract document. Work identified in the contract and further discussed and developed in greater detail in the contract document is further explained as part of the pre-bid meeting, which take place for each contract and are highly recommended for interested bidder. The information on the pre-bid meeting can be found on the A1 page of the document. This plaza program will span across many tollway departments, contractors, projects, and vendors, both internal and external. It is very important to maintain strong coordination throughout the project and among the tollway team. From the tollway's perspective, the project manager, the construction manager, and the contractor are all responsible for the successful delivery of this effort. We want to bring emphasis to the strong coordination needed across departments and business sectors that will be critical in advancing the work of these contracts. The tollway will shepherd this coordination and help provide the vehicle to bring together these key stakeholders as part of this process. The diagrams in green represent the tollway departments that will be needed to engage in this effort. The gray diagrams are vendors already working and engaged with the tollway to deliver the elements of this work. Additional details on roles and responsibilities are highlighted in the contracting bidding document. It is engineering's commitment to prospective bidders that all projects will succeed, and upon completion of the project, contractors new to the tollway will have an understanding of the tollway's organization and processes. In short, we are here to help you every step of the way. I should also note that due to these projects being an open procurement, if there are any project-specific questions, bidders should refer to the A1 page of the contract document, where an email address is provided. All questions asked prior to the question deadline will be provided to all plan holders through an addendum. A number of contracts are quickly approaching this deadline, so please review this soon if interested in bidding these projects. As mentioned on the previous slide, this slide highlights where prospective bidders can retrieve the plans from the tollway's website by accessing the online plan room. In the plan room, you'll be able to get the contract specifications, drawings, pay item list, also known as the P pages, and all other applicable contract documents regarding ongoing contracting opportunities. An account must be made or must be created to download these resources, but this is a simple registration process. Each contract will provide a list of firms who are interested in pursuing these opportunities, and this can be found under the Plan Holders tab. The contractor checklist is shown here for those firms interested in bidding these Plaza improvement opportunities. Bidders should refer to the Volume 1 of the contract document for specific requirements. As a reminder, the Illinois Tollway no longer accepts manual hard copy bid submissions. Bids must be submitted through Bid By, the state of Illinois' e-procurement system. I'll pass it back to Marlene.
Next, we'll talk about assembling a team. Putting together your team of SBI registered contractors to pursue one of these contracts can happen in a variety of ways. For example, the state of Illinois keeps a record of all registered small businesses, which can be sorted by trade. Registered businesses receive an NIGP code, and for this scope of work, we've highlighted several relevant codes there on the screen that may be of interest to contractors. This list is definitely not exhaustive, but at least the core areas. In addition, the Tollway has a list of registered contractors who are also registered, which is a requirement, as a small business with the Tollway. This is another great resource available to bidders. I would like to point out that this presentation will be available afterwards. It will be posted as a PDF, and the PDF will have live links. When potential bidders review contracting opportunities, they must register with an account in the Tollway's online plan room. Those registered who have pulled plans for the contract are recorded for public viewing on the website. Finally, the Tollway often engages contractors in forums such as these, resources for upcoming networking events and previous events that have been recorded can be found on the diversity page. The link is embedded in this slide. Today, we will also have a networking session that you will see the link in the chat. Please make yourselves available for this. I think it would really help. Additional resources are the technical assistance providers. They can assist with project estimating, bid submittal, small business registration. And what we've done here is that we've listed the direct emails for everyone you can get a hold of throughout the 5 TA centers in the technical assistance network. Please use these resources. The contact information is available not only here, but also on our website. And we hope to see you bid on the projects.
Thank you both, Laura and Marlene. Great presentation. At this time, if anyone in the attendees side has any questions, please feel free to enter them in the chat box. Also, I have entered the networking session link. It will be following this webinar that we are hosting live. You'll have an opportunity to unmute yourself, talk about your company, and talk about what kind of business you can do as far as small business initiative. So we'll start that at 3:30. And it looks like we've got some questions coming in. So the first question, can you explain in greater detail how the online plan room works?
Marina, do you want to pull up the slide?
Yeah.
So the Tollway's online plan room can be found, I'm just double checking what we posted. So if you follow these two links, which I've previously give you guys the information on. Then you can go into the public bid. Actually, does it make more sense for me to share my screen or no? Sorry.
Sure, you can share your screen. Let me give you that power. Give me one moment.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, perfect. So this, once you follow those two links on the Tollway's website, it'll take you to the online plan room. Typically, you can click on the all public bids provided. This is where all of the bids that are open, that are on the street currently, will be. And so, for instance, you can pull, let's see. Just pull one up. So 4560 is one of the Plaza improvement contracts. On here, you have the general information of the details of the contract. You've got the plans located in the second tab. Within here, you can view your document. You've got tabs for the specifications, so the A1 page, the P page. Any reference manuals, the ROSIP manual can be found here. And then any, often double check this one as well. There is sometimes reference documents called out in the specs, so those can be found there as well. Addendums will be posted here. As you can see, this addendum is already posted. And then this last tab is the plan holders, which we referenced earlier as well. And so you can see those that have pulled the plans as well as the assist agencies.
One of the things that you can do, if you want to contact an assist agency, they'll have the plans, just arrange for them to view them, and they can help you from there.
Thank you, Marlene and Laura. I have another question. This is pertaining to ROSIP. Subs are responsible for deductibles in the ROSIP. How does one estimate the possible cost of that when estimating?
Marlene, I don't have the answer to this question. Could it be submitted in writing that we could provide the answer directly?
I would also say that, especially if you're looking on how to remember that ROSIP only covers certain types of insurance, and the prime is responsible for the rest. I would suggest that you get a hold of one of the technical assistance providers who are well versed in how to bidding and estimating and everything having to do with that, as well as definitely submit that to for the contract in question.
Another great resource is the ROSIP at getipass.com email address. So if you have any ROSIP questions, you can submit them there. I'll put that in the chat also, as well as a follow-up to that question. All right, I have another question here. Do you consider MOT as having an on-site exposure if only delivering and pickup of the equipment?
Can you repeat that question?
Do you consider MOT as having on-site exposure, even if they're only delivering and picking up equipment?
I'm not sure I fully understand the question.
I think it sounds like that's a question that would go to risk. Because that's very detailed, having to do with that scope. I would submit that with the to the contract that you're interested in bidding. And remember, these questions can be whether you're a prime or a sub. If you have a question about the or looking in at those roles, if you have a question about the any part of the contract, please just submit it.
I just entered the email address. You can submit ROSIP questions to. And we also do have the SBI email address for any SBI questions, which I'll also put in the chat box. And another comment was made, but from someone from the Tollway. Also remember, we do have a webinar series page on the website under the diversity section. We have had a couple of ROSIP webinars that have been recorded and posted on there. So if you have questions, they were very thorough. Please take the time to visit and take a look at those recordings. And we've got a couple more questions here. What kind of codes does this SBI go for? The state of Illinois, does it use NAICS codes or NIGP codes?
For the application, we actually ask for both. Siobhan, you may want to, if you have more information on that.
Yes, we're requesting both codes for the application. We'll put the link for the NAICS code website, where if you're not sure about which code to select, you can put the specialty area in the search and it'll provide you with a code that's comparable to the code that you have with the state.
Okay, so then the question is, since you can't enter both, is that the process, Siobhan? You do the crosswalk?
No, we request both on our application. So both are required. When you submit the application for SBI, okay, we require both codes.
Okay, thank you. Let me see if there's any more in here. We are a trucking and hauling contractor. I don't believe you separate trucking for these bids. Similar to the larger packages, will the plan holders be listed for us to contact?
The plan holders are found on the online plan room that I just went through. It is the fifth tab to the right to kind of click on each contract. We can also, I know that you guys are hosting the networking session after this. That'll help you kind of get in contact with a number of other firms that are bidding contracts. Say Marlene, feel is that obviously reach out to those technical assistant agencies. They'll be able to also help you.
Okay, with that said, I don't have any more questions. Siobhan, you want to close us off? And just a reminder to everyone, there is going to be a networking session. I've put the link in the chat. I'll put it in there one more time. And that will serve as soon as you finish this one. And you will have an opportunity to introduce yourselves, talk about a little bit your company, and we'll identify what type of work you can do on SBI upcoming projects.
Okay. For the Lorena, you have the slide up for the most up-to-date information?
Yes, let me put it back up. Give me a moment.
Okay. Okay, so for the most up-to-date information on upcoming contracting opportunities, please visit the Tollway's website at illinoistollway.com, the ultimate resource for doing business with the Tollway. Under the Doing Business tab, you'll find information on our diversity programs and outreach, the construction bid letting schedule, professional service bulletin look-ahead schedule, information on the Tollway's buying plan, information on getting certified or pre-qualified, resources including our online plan room and videos on submitting bids on Tollway's work, and how to sign up to receive emails from CMS when new procurement opportunities are available. Thank you again for attending today's presentation. Please join us next week for IDOT-DDE certification webinar. Have a good evening and stay safe.